background and leveraging its strong human capital and strong business environment. These are the key strengths of Pune. And because of that, Pune aspires as one of the most livable, resilient, smart cities in India. And its core infrastructural issues are future-proof, and we are trying to make our neighborhoods beautiful, clean, green, and livable. So, smart nutrition is little bit new concept, and this is a different topic which also needs to be addressed in the city. Earlier there was hardly any awareness of diets, but now it has evolved in basically in the urban sector. It has evolved tremendously. People know more about health, but and they don't want to opt on medicines, but they have to change their dietary functioning. So today's lifestyle has led to cause many diseases, and because of increasing of fast food consumption, it has linked with increasing obesity. So every urban area is facing such type of problems. So this has resulted into serious concern. Like when you see the hospitals in the city, you will see they are always overcrowded because of the various diseases. So nutrition has a lot of scope to deal with such type of activities. Last year we have studied, our educational officers are there, we have studied about the adolescent girls who are studying in municipal schools, and the response we surveyed about 24,000 girls, and the response we received that 20% girls are facing problems with anemia because of low rate of hemoglobin. They faced problems related to defective vision. They faced problems of tooth decay because of lacking of vitamin D. In PMC, municipal schools, if you see that there are girls of economically backward classes. So again, we will be forwarding this survey this year also. What measures we did in the last year, are we improving or not? So I think this smart nutrition program will help us in creating good atmosphere among these adolescent girls. And Dr. Phillips has read a very good issue about generations to be nutritionized. It's a I think it's a very different perspective to this smart city nutrition program. And one experience I wanted to share with you, that when I was working with an NGO called Community Aid and Sponsorship Program, we used to work in the field of children. But when we started working, when a child in his mother's womb, we started working on that, and that gave us very different aspects and very fantastic results we received. So I think Now we are trying in Pune Municipal Corporation. You have visited our some hospitals, Mother Milk Bank, which will help us that mother who cannot lactate her child can have a child can have mother milk. So such kind of activities will help child to get neutralized properly. So and the mission, smart city mission itself has aim of people's participation in every part of the society. Every part of the society should take participation in this mission. So not only in the infrastructural facilities we are providing such type of activities, and I thank you all that you have also taken this initiative, and this joint partnership between Pune and Birmingham will be a platform to enable joint learning, experience sharing, and also piloting of specific initiatives. So it's a good interaction, and I think in today's program we will find out, we can find out some type of solutions that we can observe in both the cities. So lastly, I thank the entire participant for sparing some time for this stakeholder meeting, and hope this interaction will benefit both the cities and ultimately result into smart nutrition cities. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am, for sharing your strong and valuable thoughts. Now I would like to invite Dr. Anjali Sabne to give vote of thanks.
The first half of today's stakeholders meeting was very informative, and now it's the time for the thanksgiving session. In the beginning, I would like to thank our Mayor of Pune City, Mukta Tilak Madam, for extending her warm welcome to all the dignitaries on the dais and all those who have come from Birmingham City, and for sharing her views and experiences of Pune City regarding nutrition. I thank the Deputy Mayor, Dr. Dhinde sir, for sharing so much of data and being here with us today. I thank Paula Hamilton Madam for giving her valuable time for coming all the way from Birmingham City to Pune, for sharing the highlights of her visits which we had yesterday, and especially for talking about the realization of our mistakes which she was mentioning. It's actually mistakes on both the sides regarding nutrition, and especially I think for reminding us of the previous name of Pune City, which was Punaudi. She kept saying Pune, Pune, and it reminded us of our previous name which we had. I thank our additional commissioner general Sheetal Teliugle madam for sharing all the learnings and experiences of the Birmingham City visit. I thank Anna Taylor from Food Foundation for the wonderful presentation which she made here. I thank Mrs. Shirin for being here from Tata Trust, which is supporting this partnership between Pune City and Birmingham City. I thank Dr. Adrian for the valuable guidance which he gave, and especially for mentioning that we have forgotten food, which was a very important statement which he made. And in the end, I would like to thank Shaleen, who's been here from Birmingham, who was there when we visited Birmingham. She was showing us around, and we had all the visits along with her. I thank all the NGOs and all the Pune Municipal Corporation officers for being here, for giving their valuable time, and we'll have a participation session in the next half. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.